take you out for a walk with me to kind of show you something important about the way the human mind works. And I would be willing to bet that there's several of you on here who are more experts in psychology and understand it better than me. But if I tell you right now not to look at the tree over my shoulder, you are totally going to look at the tree over my shoulder. And if I tell you, hey, look at my collarbones, you are totally going to look at my collarbones just as readily as you looked at the tree over my shoulder, right? And so that's the way that the human brain works. We don't handle not very well. Our brain kind of registers it almost the same as do. And it's if somebody tells you not to tuck your pelvis or not to tuck your bum underneath of you, it's really hard to do that. It almost makes you want to do it because what is the other option? The only thing you know is the thing that we just talked about. And so if you want to find a way to not tuck your bum under you, so if you want to find a way to not tuck your bum, there is a reason that you're tucking your bum and you need a different do. You need a different strategy. And so hopefully that's what I am sharing with you in my reel today, is that if you strengthen your glutes and you strengthen your abs, then they can help provide stability to your pelvis and your pelvic floor doesn't have to work as much. And it will also probably help you if you have an awareness in your brain of what length in your pelvic floor feels like. So elongate your pelvic floor, know how to do that, and then know how to turn up your glutes and your abs so that you can turn down your pelvic floor. All right, let me know what questions you have.
So if you have an avulsion, that means that part of the pelvic floor muscle has torn away from the bone. That means that there's less support for your pelvic organs. It means